is a story, a spiritual tragedy. I know some listeners are bound to be mad at me. The way things look, I knew that it had to be. Time to talk of things that are sad to see. Nowadays, it's not safe to watch TV. Forget about the sex and violence, you see. I know these things may cause concern, but that's not how the church really gets burned. I'm speaking about the slick-looking preachers, ones that claim to be great Bible teachers. I really pray to God that they never reach you, because I know all they want to do is just cheat you. I think you know just who I mean, the slick false prophet on your TV screen. Two brown eyes, kind of shifty and beady. A man whose whole heart is endlessly greedy. Hair slicked back, sued by Armani. With all his words, he's just trying to con me. He gives a wink and a friendly sort of smile, all part of his devious style. Through the magic of TV comes in your home, on the late nights when you feel all alone. He has a Bible in his hand, he can't be all bad. And right there is where you've just been had. No smoother con artist have I ever seen. It's simple wizardry the way he works his scheme. There's no doubt in my mind you'll fall for his line, cause the Bible in his hand makes it all sound fine. Send some money, please send it fast. My ministry is running real low on cash. If you send me a dollar, God will give you two. No need to check your Bible. Would he lie to you? Pulls up with his brand new Jaguar. The wife puts the meat in the back of the car. Gospel preaching is taking them far. And on Sunday mornings, you know who's the star. Sure, they say they come to worship Christ. They may even use his precious name once or twice. Maybe mutter a vain and empty prayer. But the man up front is why they all are here. I can't believe he claims to be a pastor. He really is just a spiritual disaster. Scheming and conniving, he's surely the master. Conning for the money, faster and faster. He's wreaking havoc on the church of God. It doesn't matter how many lives get scarred. He hits the wallets and purses real hard, and collects the dough in really big fat wads. He leaves a trail of broken hearts and dreams of the people all taken in by his schemes. He offered so much hope for lives of despair. Went down in his calloused heart, he didn't care about these people and all of their problems. He simply lied and he told them he could solve them, so he could get the cash and be on his way. Waiting for the chance to scheme on another day, he pulled the wool over many eyes. When he speaks his words about to mesmerize, I'm afraid you won't see through his clever lies. He's a ravenous wolf in a sheep's disguise. Cheat on tax, he won't call it stealing. You're feeling sick, he'll give you a healing. Everyone has such positive feeling. No wonder his message is so appealing. Never heard him talking of the cross of Christ or the need for folks to live a holy life. That in this life we have trials and strife. He just doesn't feel those doctrines are nice. I must say, he perfectly timed it. All their eyes so spiritually blinded, all their thoughts so carnally minded. Greedy for money and how they can find it. It wasn't hard to get the masses to follow when you make the gospel easy to swallow. Telling the crowd just what they wanted to hear. He's a master at tickling the itching air. Eloquent speech filled with words of vanity, subtly deceiving so much of humanity. Teaching devilish demonic insanity, making mockery of all Christianity. This is a matter of spiritual survival. Beware of those who misuse the Bible. Wells without water, cloud without rain. To them, godliness is a means to gain. About 13 years that he's been tickling the itching ears, making sure that he calms all their fears, teaching them exactly what they wanted to hear. I think God is about to settle the score. In the distance, I can hear a mighty roar. The floods of judgment is about to pour, and this messenger of lies will be no more. The preacher man is gonna see he's out of time. In the morning paper, the faker will find God is editor-in-chief of Truth to Justice Times, and written by God on the front page headline. Phony preacher has been caught in a scandal. God Almighty snuffed him out like a candle. His lies have caught him. It's more than he can handle. He
proved to be just a fraud and a vandal. Although he preached, I guess he didn't know what was meant by the verse, you'll reap what you sow. Just when his audience had started to grow, God pulled a final curtain on his fiendish show. Now look at who the last joke is on, and like a puff of smoke, the faker is gone. Satan will send another on his way, but I know Lord God will have the final say.
Thank you.